We have a new album out called Spirit. It's just, I'm not even sure it's in the store yet. It's just coming out. Thank you very much.
I'm waiting forever for you. This is my destiny. This is what I am to do.
But forever. I had an album that I had recorded. It's the Spirit album, and I produced it and recorded it in Austin, Texas. And I was looking for a label. And at the same time, Don Was, producer friend of mine, had suggested that we might go into the studio sometime and do a reggae album that he thought perhaps Island Records might be interested in. So with that in mind, we went in the studio and we did a reggae song. We did one of my songs with a reggae rhythm, and turned out good, so we thought we'd play it for Island Records. So we flew to Jamaica, and we met with Chris Blackwell of Island Records, and while I was there, I thought it might be a good idea to play the Spirit album for Chris Blackwell also, and he liked it very much. The Spirit album is, being a concept album, I took four of my earlier songs and I wrote seven new songs. The four songs that I added from the past were 17-year-old songs, and then the new stuff I've written in the last 6 months. When I go back to a song, I find that I go back to that point in time, and when I'm singing that song, I find myself a lot of times back in that situation. It's good, I think, for the feel of the song. It's not always that pleasant. I pretty much knew what I wanted to do when I went to the studio, because I'd had a while to work on it, and since it was a very sparsely recorded, I didn't need that many musicians, so it went fairly quickly. The Spirit album covers a 17-year period, a 17-year concept. The concept being the spirit rising, going from low spirits to high spirits.
We've got a real great guest visiting with us this week, a boy that we've been knowing for quite a long while, and he's written some wonderful songs, and he is not only a songwriter, but a wonderful singer, too. Willie Nelson! Come out here! Do us a pretty song.
All right. I'd like to do a song. This is a brand new one of mine called She's Not For You. Pay no mind to her. She only wants to play. But she's not for you. She's not for you. So she told you she found heaven in your eyes. Well, I think it only fair to warn you that sometimes she lies, but it's your heart. I can't tell you what to do, but she's not for you. She's not for you.
Do writers speak for the people? I think they do. Well, I think that's why in the beginning I learned songs by other writers, why I learned to do Hank Williams songs or Floyd Tillman songs, because these writers were saying what I wanted to say. I felt like that I wanted to write something, and I felt like I wanted to say something, and whether it was something someone else would want to say or not, I didn't write it off as not being. I gave it an opportunity. I felt like that I wasn't that much different, really, from other people. I try to say what I think I would feel, knowing that most other people's emotions are the same, basically.
Our buddy, the Buddha, a boy, man, biker, priest, sage pop star, peddler of perfect tunes, a smoking, token, jock choking movie star, truck driving ballet singer, whose whispers are louder than all the rock bands in the world, and who must be the star of his own song, Angel Flying Too Close to the Ground. Yep, that's Willie Nelson to me.
We don't run, and we don't compromise, and we don't quit, we never do. We look for love, find it in the eyes of me and the eyes of you. You are the road, you are the only way. I'll follow you forevermore. We'll look for love, we'll find it in the eyes that see through all the doors. There is a train that races through the night, rails of steel that reach the soul, fueled by fire as soft as candlelight, warms the heart of a love grown cold. Here we go. We don't run, and we don't compromise, we don't quit, we never do. We look for love and find it in the eyes of me and the eyes of you. Words that feel and words that sympathize, words that heal and understand. Say them now, let them materialize. Say the words throughout the land. That we don't run.
I do feel that we're responsible for the land. I think probably that's why Farm Aid was started, probably why I started it, because I really do believe the value of the land. I believe it has to be cared for, and it has to be cared for by people who really love the land, knowing how important the land is and how important it is to take care of this acre of land, because they're not making any more land. It's not like everything else that if you run out, you can go to a store and buy some more. You can't buy new land. And when you use it up, it's gone. And it could take years or forever to get back to its original state. That's why it's so tragic to see families have to leave a place where they grew up, where their parents and grandparents grew up, and it was handed down to them, a farm, a home. And when they lose their business, they also lose their home. In America, we have, well, we used to have over 8 million small family farmers. Now we're down to less than 2 million, closer to 1 million, actually losing 500 a week. And that's a continued process. It's this week, next week, last week. So eventually, we will have no more small family farmers, and all the land will be under the supervision of huge conglomerates, which I don't think is the best thing for the land. I think we can learn a lot from our native brothers, because they had to depend on the land to support them and feed them for so long that they do realize the value.
Gypsies, we go down the highway. The best of friends.
This might be really
good. Sing a song. I thought it was real special that my sister for sure played on this album, because her and I have played together since we were very small. And she knows instinctively what I'm going to do. And I know that she's going to be there. So there's a understanding there that carries into the studio. And it's just very comfortable to have her there, because I know what she's going to do is going to be right for what I want to hear. And the same thing for the rest of the guys in the band, Jody Payne, who played on this album, and Johnny Gimbo, who played violin. I've worked with both of them so much that they also know instinctively when to play, when not to play, what to play.
So I'm not trying to forget you anymore. And I've got back into remembering all the love we had before. And I've been trying to forget someone that my heart still adores. So I'm not trying to forget you anymore. And I'm not trying to forget you anymore.
Gospel music has probably been a great influence, because my first songs that I remember hearing were gospel songs that I learned in church and that I sang in church and my sister played. And so a lot of the melodies, I'm sure, I've probably borrowed along the way parts of them to write whatever I write, and hopefully not too much, but I know there's some influence there.
Here's Willie Nelson.
I used to walk stooped from the weight of my tears, but I just started laying my burdens down. And I used to duck bullets from the rifle of fear, but I just started laying my burdens down. Oh, well, I'm laying them down. I just started laying my burdens down. Oh, I'm laying them down. I just started laying my burdens down. Mama, can I come on home? And I just started laying my burdens down. And God said, son, you ain't never been gone. And I just started laying my burdens down. Oh, and I'm laying them down. I just started laying my burdens down. Oh, and I'm laying them down. I just started laying my burdens down. I'm laying them down. I just started laying my
Well, yeah. When I first heard Elvis, I was a disc jockey myself. I was playing all country music, or what I wanted to play, really. And I played Elvis all the time. I thought he was a progressive thinker also. I thought he was a progressive musician. And in fact, he sort of started what some people call rock and roll. I called it progressive country.
Outback it's showing Buffalo with us and Kitty Wells and Charlie Fry. The show was long, we're sitting there, and we'd come to play, not just for the ride. Yeah, we drank a lot of whiskey, so I don't know if we went on that night at all. But I don't think they even missed us. I guess Buffalo just ain't geared for me and Paul. It's been rough and rocky traveling, I finally got my feet back on the ground. After taking several readings, I'm surprised to find my mind still fairly sound. I guess Nashville was the roughest, but I know I've said the same about them all. We received our education in the cities of the nation, me and Paul. Received our education in the cities of this nation, me and Paul. So anyway, that song probably pretty much sums up Willie. Me and Paul. He's so unique and so genuinely
different, and I don't use that term lightly in referring to Willie Nelson. He is really the litmus test for difference in country music. And anybody who comes along and says they're doing something different in country music should be measured against Willie Nelson.
My guitar has memories and a mind of its own and a heart and soul and all those things. And if there was ever a guitar that had a song in it, it would be that.
I thought about you and the songs that I keep singing. I thought about you and the joy that they keep bringing. And I thought about life and a love that has no ending. I thought about you, Lord. I thought about you. I thought about you, Lord. I thought about you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.